Welcome to Dubai, 47. Today is the inauguration of the scepter, and the ceremony is well underway. You will find Marcus Stuyvesant near the building's signature art installation. While a paranoid Carl Ingram has ensconced himself in his penthouse suite, security on highest alert. Mr. Gray is already in position and ready to assist. Good luck, 47.
Come in. 47, do you copy?
I'm here.
Are you in position?
I'm heading towards the point of entry.
Good. Get back to me when you're there. Use your camera and scan the lock, will you? I think I can override the window's controls from here.
I'm in position.
47, the inauguration is taking place close by. Once you've infiltrated it, get your bearings. I'm sure there must be floor plans somewhere.
Understood.
We need absolute focus on this one. If Ingram and Stuyvesant are alerted to our presence, we may lose them for good. We are so close, 47.
Don't worry. They're not going anywhere.
On behalf of His Royal Highness Omar Al-Ghazali, I bid you welcome to the scepter.
Welcome!
Welcome.
Hello!
Good to see you. How lovely to see so many familiar faces here.
Please,
this has been a dream of mine for a great many years. And as all of you know, I am from one of the less privileged sides of the respectful Al-Ghazali family. But with a small loan from my father, I soon built up a construction empire that was worthy of the great Al-Ghazali legacy. So, I would like to thank my cousins, without whose friendship and influence this achievement might be. Thank you. I'm proud to yet again immortalize our great family name. But most important, this building is before, which is today the tallest building in the world. I'm very proud to watch it. So I'm humbly proud to open the Burj Al-Ghazali.
Listen. I want to talk to the partners directly. Make them understand why all of this is happening. And that terminal gives me an idea. There's a server room near the Sheikh's personal reception. If you can gain access to it, we might be able to recover useful intel from it. We'll have to work together to hack the system, but it's our best shot. It looks like the staff area could provide you with a viable route to the server.
Wonderful! You know, I didn't think you'd come after your tragic loss.
Thank you, Lucy. I would love to chat, but...
Marcus Stuyvesant was a god to us struggling artists. His and your generosity helped so many.
That's kind of you. But I have a meeting.
Oh, with who? Can I come?
No, Lucy. This is a private matter. Besides, this is your big day. You should mingle. Have fun.
Oh, don't worry about that. It's my aunt.
Well, I have to go. I'll call you when I come.
I got word that he entered the building, but he hasn't reported for duty yet. Probably still down at the depot, getting his uniform. I just hope he's got his papers with him. I heard rumors that he used to work for that Dawood Rangan. You know, the Bollywood producer who died? Doesn't sound promising.
There's quite a bit of security here.
No.
One moment. You ready for some more fresh air, 47? Stuyvesant is expecting a replacement guard. If you can locate him, we should be able to get within strangling.
Mind, do you? Oh, I really think you are putting on a brave face. You shouldn't be hiding back here. You should be out there.
What's the update on my new guard? My current one has been on duty for way too long. I need security that's sharp and focused.
Sir, we have word that he's arrived. I'm just waiting for him to turn up.
Good. Remember to check his papers before you call me. I don't want some snot-nosed newbie.
I'll be sure to contact you as soon as he turns up. Papers vetted and all.
Good. And please, when I come back, no more excuses. I'm a personal friend of His Royal Highness Omar Al-Ghazali.
Marcus Stuyvesant won't be a problem anymore. Let's move on to Carl Ingram. We're not done yet.
Okay, just wanted to remind you about the lockdown room. Tomorrow. That's right, 900 hours. And the key cards to activate the alarms are still in the safe in the security room. Yeah, same code. 6927. Just don't tell your mother I'm to shoot. Okay. Okay, but remember, you need to activate the alarm on both floors, otherwise nothing's gonna happen. Good. Yeah, we'll do. Have a good shift tomorrow. Talk to you later. Bye.
How are you, sir?
I'm sorry, Mr. Ingram gave specific instructions. No noise of any kind. He's working, he doesn't want to be disturbed.
I get the radio, but if I don't vacuum, I'll get fired.
It's not my problem. You do what you have to do without making a noise.
That's Carl Ingram, Providence partner and brass balls billionaire. A legendary political fixer, Ingram is old money and as rotten as they come.
Always thought I was a man of letters. Not as easy as it sounds.
Okay, need a drink.
company one always wants peace and quiet.
And like all the great chess masters of our time, patience is the key. This is the fundamental rule when recruiting. Explain. I would like to share a story, a fable. Soldier, a lonely boy who came from a less than modest home, showed from an early age signs of great intelligence and inventiveness. Something that no one noticed in his teaching. Now, thanks to her keen eye, she began to push little Jeffrey harder, believing he could make something of himself.
Not bad. I need to run okay. That's enough for now. All those ants down there. Most of them wouldn't be here if it wasn't for us. Little do they know that there's a war going on. Wonder if there are any other blood-sucking journalists down there.
Jeffrey excelled. Lo and behold, he started to gain, what do they call them, scholarships. Soon to be admitted into schools that his parents could not afford, and everyone believed that it was due to his brilliance, but that fate had dealt him such a generous hand. Now, this was partially true, except fate is not abstract. It's tangible. Identity was a gift from Mount Olympus, if you will.
That's enough for now.
You are way too close to me.
Hello,
and
you're
really freaking me out. Can you just leave me, please?
Hi.
And it's on. Now, after graduating from an Ivy League college, full honors, Jeffrey wanted to make a difference. He was brilliant, but he was an idealist, and he started working for what he believed was a greater cause. Fate, however, felt he would be more useful in the private sector and set itself out to lure him to his true calling, working for the hand that fed him. Grooming Fate's own image. When he was needed, when that fateful day finally arrived, Jeffrey, unknown to himself, was now under fate. Oh.
I need a break, though. That was good. I think I'll have a drink. Just what the doctor ordered. One more.
Yes, sir. It'll be waiting for you when you need it.
Thanks.
History of the Partners. As my successor, it's important you understand that we, the Partners, are a collective of distinguished families who have taken. A place where the intelligent and the strong can prosper. But we also understand where there are masters, there must be servants. This cannot be done without an effective class system. The servants must be controlled.
Okay, that's enough for now. Okay, rolling.
So, it's our duty to, to keep the world in check, to make sure the engine runs smoothly and not dissolve into anarchy. And that might sound harsh, but it is our fundamental belief that the masses must be guided as they are incapable of guiding themselves. However, these ideals could be misinterpreted as some form of dictatorship, and this is where I beg to differ. We are anything but, which is also why it is imperative that we, the Partners, maintain our clandestine approach. The masses like to be led, but the trick is...
Looking very well today, sir.
Stop.
to our successes. So return.
What?
Alert to our failure. Oh. We're just with Bruce.
We got him, 47. Soon there will be no more Providence. You need to find an exit. Our business is done here, but it's far from over.
Five, Echo Foxtrot, come in.
Clear out of here.
Some
now.
Maniac is on a killing spree. Look for a bald man in the sky. I've arrived at location and it's over.
All right, man. Special forces are here. Game is over.